Yeah,
My
there's
God.
some problem going on with reminders, I guess. Learners are not getting reminders 1 hour before the class. Maybe that's why people are not coming into the classes.
Is that a glitch at the moment?
Yep. That's a glitch.
Okay, well, let's hope that that glitch will disappear and everything will go back to normal.
Yeah.
So we just right, we're live streaming. This is another one of the new classes, so it should be very interesting as
Please make
to
me co-host.
okay, yeah, more co-host. There we go. You are co-host.
Thank
Excellent.
you.
Do you have birds in your garden, Harry?
Actually, yeah, we have birds here, but I really don't know their names.
They're just
Yeah,
pretty
they are nice.
birds. They're pretty
Yeah.
birds.
Yeah.
There are pretty birds and they're not so pretty birds. Oh, they're ones that we used to call the LBJs, little brown jobs, because we didn't know
Yeah.
what they were.
Yeah, they are, I know them. Yeah, they are small brown birds. Yeah.
No idea. And there are lots of different varieties as well. So
Yeah.
I get I'm not a birder as such. I just enjoy the birds in my garden.
Okay.
And there's a big difference. Birders know exactly what it is, its call, where it should be, how it works, and
Yeah.
the whole fruity toot.
How they travel and like that, yeah,
Yeah,
things like that.
the whole thing. So yeah, they are very, very passionate about their birds. I just enjoy my birds. I just love the
Yeah.
birds that are in my garden. And we're getting more and more of the parrots coming into our garden and the lorikeets coming into our garden. And so we are all they all are part of the same family, but they are so beautiful. In South Africa, if we saw them, we would go, ooh. Who's lost their parrot? You know, it's be disappeared out of somebody's cage. While
Oh.
here we've got the opposite. They are wild here. You walk through,
Yes.
we've got a little forest about 50 meters from our home, and
Same. Yeah.
we go out there and we walk with the dogs every day
Okay.
in that. And the if we go at about 4, half past 4 in the afternoon when the sun is starting to set at the moment because of being winter. The bird song there is unbelievable. Early in the morning and late afternoon, you get every kind of bird singing. It really is beautiful. Right, I'm going to take off the security and start the recording. All right. Hi, Carmen. Hi, David. David's iPad. Could be David, could be a he or a she. Hi, Carmen. Welcome to class. Her audio is just connecting. There she is. Hi, Carmen. Where are you from? Which part of the world are you from? Or David, either of you? Which part of the world do you come from? Okay. Yes, David's iPad. Where are you from?
I'm from New York.
From New York. Okay, right, David. I'm interested to find out what kind of birds you've got in New York. We're looking at birds around the world. We're going to see what I've got in my garden, and then I'm hoping you're all going to share your different ones that you've got. Debbie, where are you from? Debbie's on mute at the moment. Okay, no problem. Right, I just want to wait a couple of minutes before starting. What this is social hours. It's a time when we can all share the different birds and animal birds that we have in our gardens. I'm very fortunate living where I do because we have a beautiful beautiful birds in our gardens. We have a lot of the parrots that come to visit the garden. And I come from South Africa, and if we saw parrots, we'd go, "Oh, who's lost their parrot?" Yeah, they are naturally wild here. And so it's so different into what we have in our gardens. And I'm so looking forward to hearing the different birds that you have as well. I'm not a birder as such. I just enjoy my birds. And so I'm hoping that you do too. Hi, Mary Ellen. Lovely to have you in class again. Great to see you again. Awesome. Lovely to be part of the class. Oh, and there comes Diane. Hi, Diane. Lovely to have you as well. Ah, here we go. Now we're getting all the different people. Hi, Diane. Back again. Lovely to have you again. Excellent. Diane was in our pet one this morning and it was awesome. All right. I'm going to start sharing my screen. We have Harry with us. He is my TA. If you have any problems, please feel free to contact him and or find any assistance with anything that you have a problem with. Right. So let's start sharing our creations. Now, as I said to you before, I am so fortunate with where I live because we have amazing birds. So we learn from each other. So if you put your cameras on, that is awesome. I'm able to see your faces, see, be able to chat to you. If you don't want your camera on, it's equally fine. Just if you just communicate, that's what's important as well. Anybody joining by live streaming, unfortunately, you won't be able to communicate, but I hope you enjoy the class as well. And we're not paid to promote products, but there's might be one in my thing. Right. A little about me. My name is Sue. I live in Perth, Australia. I have been here for 3 years now. My husband and I moved here to help look after the grandchildren. We used to live in South Africa, where there were also different beautiful birds as well. Michael is all my husband. Michael's also a guide on Get Set Up, so it's awesome. We're a team together. I've been an educator for 44 years, but what I love about Get Set Up is that I don't educate, I share. I share my ideas, I share things with others. I learned so much from everybody that is in the classes, and for me, that's great. I enjoy creating and making things, especially puzzles, and my love, I have a great love of animals. That's why I do my animal series on African animals, Australian animals, encounters with animals, different things that have happened to me or animals that I know of in the different countries. So let's begin. Welcome to my garden. This is my garden. It's not a big garden. It's a little garden. But we have tried to make it as friendly for all the birds and animals, creatures that come into my garden. I am so fortunate. Michael's got the green fingers. I know what I want, and he does all the work, and he talks to the plants and gets them growing. So we have a very beautiful little garden that we have set up. And so I collect gnomes. I love gnomes. And so welcome to my gnome garden. Right. This trellis in the center where the bird feeder is where we have most of our action in our garden. So who can tell me some birds that you have in your garden? These are just two that come to my garden, and they are really beautiful birds to have in the garden. Who can tell me a bird that this is called a ring-necked parrot, because it's got that bright yellow ring round its neck. And they come to the bird feeder and spend many happy hours. And then they drop all the seed off the top. And then the bandicoot comes in from the forest. We have a little forest about 50 meters from us. And he comes into our garden and feeds every day. He was here about half an hour ago. He was busy feeding and collecting all the seed he could find that had been dropped. So who can tell me some birds that they have in their gardens? Mary Ellen, what have you got?
Well, today we had some cardinals and a lot of wrens and some red-winged blackbirds and a robin.
Wow, you had a lovely selection in your garden today. Diane, what have you seen today?
Well, I don't really know much about birds, but I have these beautiful little hummingbirds that come right outside my window.
Oh, beautiful. Ah, they are. They apparently, their wings beat at something like 600 times per second in order to, that's why you hear that humming sound. It's actually the beating of the wings that does it. And that is, for me, awesome. I mean, I can't even flap my fingers more than 10 times a second. So you can imagine how fast those wings must be going.
Hello, is this the place where we talk about birds?
Oh, yes, it is. Hi, Peter. Welcome. Hi. Welcome to it. Welcome to our class. Lovely to have you. We've just started and I introduced my little garden and I'm just asking everybody what they've seen today. Susan, what have you seen today?
We have morning doves. And occasionally we get a couple grackles. And then we have I think it's the red-headed woodpecker. So comes by and you can hear him calling when he pecks.
So that is so close to the house. But that's okay. You can hear him. It's like us with the kookaburra. When they're in the little forest next to us, we can hear the kookaburra calling. And he's a laughing kookaburra. And he's got this thing that comes from his toes all the way up. And he sounds like he has just heard the funniest joke in the world. All right. And David, what do you see in New York?
Well, I've seen some robins and blue jays and a cardinal.
Nice.
I don't know. That's about all I've seen.
But there's a lot we don't see. They're there, but we don't see them. We can hear them. They are so clever. They hide and they have a wonderful time. Oh, thank you for sharing that. And Debbie, what do you see? Debbie's on mute at the moment. Okay, Peter, what do you see?
I'm in Washington and I recently saw a trumpeter swan. I live kind of near an area of water, so I get to see a lot of different kind of birds that have to do with water.
Oh, and nice.
Yeah, I saw a lot of nice birds. I think I saw a tufted titmouse the other day, and I saw a bunch of kids who were coming on my lawn and bothering the area where the birds were nesting. I had to yell at them, and I said, hey, get out of here. And then I saw a couple toads kind of jumping on top of each other. But otherwise, yeah, just a bunch of different birds. The cardinals, I think I saw a couple cardinals too.
Oh, hello, Sherry, you on mute at the moment.
Yeah, we had a very interesting class. Your husband, Michael, right?
Yes.
Yes, I was in his class just now.
Oh, okay. So you've been hopping classes today. You with me, then with him, then with me. So we're really doing the roundabout. Right, I'm going to share
She was going on and on in the last class that I was in. She just kept going on and on.
This guy, I think he, I honestly, I wonder if he's a Zoom bomb.
Zoom bomb because I'm coming in to have conversation in normal classes. I'm just trying to talk about the birds I've seen.
Oh, well, we're going to hear all about those because that's exactly what we're doing. I welcomed you all to my garden. This is my garden. It's small, but we've made it as eco-friendly as we can and as friendly for the birds that can come in. Because of being in Australia, we have very different birds to the birds that you have in America. So I love to hear about all your different birds that you have. So these ones here are the ringneck parrots. They are rather beautiful, and they come and they feed in the bird feeder every day at different times. And they've actually got quite used to us. They're quite happy if we're sitting outside, and then they come and feed. Now, here are just a few of the very beautiful ones. We installed a bell the other day of seed, and within 5 minutes these birds had arrived to have a look and see what these are. Rainbow lorikeets in the middle. They really are the most beautiful birds, with a red head, yellow, blue, red at the bottom. They are the most wonderful ones that have everything that we have along the way. They really are beautiful. And then at certain times, we are lucky enough to get the black parrot, cockatoo. Now, the black cockatoo are somewhat endangered because they like to live in 100-year-old trees, and they're not that many 100-year-old trees, particularly with the expansion of people moving into the areas where that used to just be bush. But they come and they love the bottle brush. They destroy it because they take what they want and they break off the flowers, and you get this carpet of flowers underneath because they have had a wonderful feed there. But they are such elegant birds, and they go and they sit in the top of the trees. They're usually in a flock of 5 or 6 of them, and they talk really loudly as they go along. So they really enjoy having fun in our garden. And so these are some of the parrots that you would find in my garden. Now, what I'd like you each to do is to tell me the bird that you find the most interesting that comes to your garden. So I'm going to stop sharing, and let's see who can tell me what they think is the most popular bird, or the bird that they find has the best character. At the end, I'll tell you my one. Who's going to start? How about Diane? Yes, Diane.
Okay, I just looked up the kind of hummingbird that comes to my window, and it's called the calliope hummingbird.
The calliope hummingbird. Yeah, what color is he?
It's once they come here, they're gray and a little bit of yellow and red on their neck. Very tiny.
Very tiny little hummingbirds. Wow. And let's see, Mary Ellen.
I think I like the red-winged blackbirds lately because they come and chirp at my windows, especially if they don't have enough sunflower seeds.
Ah, so they talk to you and they tell you that they are not there. You want your time. Ah, that's awesome. Right. And Peter, what is your favorite bird that you can see?
I've been seeing zoo bats in my yard lately.
Okay, I don't know those. Can you tell me what they look like?
Well, usually they're kind of like they stay in more dark areas, kind of, but sometimes I'll see them up in the light near the brush.
Okay. And what do they eat?
And then I'll see. I'm not actually sure what they're eating, but they come in there and they're messing with the brush a lot of times, I think, trying to build nests.
Okay, that's.
And the sometimes I see Charmanders too in my yard.
And what color are they?
They're an orange red color.
Orange red color. Okay, a Charmander. Wow, those are awesome. Who else would like to tell me what they are seeing? Who else can tell me what they're seeing? Sherry, would you like to tell me what you see? Nope, you're on silent.
Okay. I like the starlings.
What were the blue starling?
I don't know what color they were, but they fly in groups, big huge groups, and they just go from like tree to tree, and it's very uniform, and it's really nice. I mean, it's like a community, a uniform community.
Fantastic! That is awesome. All right. Anybody else like to tell me something that they see or that they like so much in their garden? Right. Okay.
I have what was meant to be a decorative little birdhouse and ends up being a little sanctuary for wrens that will, especially in the morning, watching them go in and out of the little birdhouse just amazes me because they're so tiny, but I didn't think they could, like I said, it's a decorative birdhouse, but it's ending up to be a real birdhouse for them.
Wow, that's a bonus, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, it's so close too, right outside my front door. I have big eaves and I hung the little decorative bird feet house, but it's getting used. So it is, yeah, but it's just amazing watching them. They're so tiny, but they can just come in and out. It's just kind of interesting watching them.
We were very fortunate in South Africa. We had black-collared barbets in our garden, and they make holes in your trees. And just outside the bedroom window was an older tree, and they made a hole at either end, and they dug all the way through. And then in the evening, we would watch them go in from one side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, into this branch. And then in the early morning, if you were up early enough, you'd watch them coming out the other end, 1, 2, 3, 4, as they came flying out. There were about 6 of them that slept in this little bit of branch that they had hollowed out, and that was their home. And every night, in from the left, right side, and up through the left, and that was the way we used to see them going in and out. I used to get up extra early just to watch it because it was something so different, and you couldn't imagine that 6 birds could squash into such a small area. They were obviously living right on top of each other at night, but that to me was so interesting that that's how they slept at night. We had very beautiful birds, some very colorful, but nothing like the parrots that we have here in Australia. Right, Debbie, would you like to tell us something about a bird that you like or you see in your garden? Anybody else? Okay, Melinda? No. All right, just now maybe you will share as well. So these are 3 of the parrots that we have in our garden, and they are really beautiful parrots, I must say. The bell, as we put that bell up, which you can see had only just gone up, within 10 minutes they were already there. How they knew it was there, I do not know, but they were ready and waiting. And of course, the bandicoot loves that because the more they drop on the floor, the more he gets to eat. And so he comes and finishes off anything on the ground. Now, these are some of the smaller birds that we have, although the raven is not so small. I used to call them crows, but apparently in Australia they call them ravens, but to me it's still a crow. He comes and sits on the fence and helps himself to the blackberries when we had blackberries. We've now taken the blackberry down and put different planter pots up instead. We have a wagtail who has taken up residence in our garden, and he chirps all day, every day. He's not scared of us. He comes right up next to us, and he guards the bird bath. And he only lets certain people onto the one bird bath. We've now put up two bird baths because he dominated the one. He wouldn't let other birds bath. So we've got a bird bath on the ground and two up that are on pedestals, so that the little ones that are the little honey, the honey eaters, they come and they, you can have up to 11 honey eaters all bathing at the same time. They make a whole ring around the bird bath. And then what they do is they then all fly in one at a time and in and out and then onto the wall to flap their wings and clean themselves up and then back down and take their turn in the water. And it is really, really beautiful to see them. But unfortunately, Waggy doesn't like them, and they play games with each other. Waggy will chase the honey eater, then the honey eater chases Waggy. And this goes on for ages, in and out of the flowers at the bottom of the garden, and then back onto the bird bath. And it is just so funny to see. But Waggy spends all day around our garden. And he's become a feature of the garden. And if you don't talk to him, he'll actually fly into where you're sitting and go just above your head and then back on out. So I just say, you haven't talked to me today. I'd like to be spoken to. So he was a very, very special bird in the garden. The little blue one, they come at this time of the year, they start, and they spend hours tapping at our windows, and they just tap, 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 and they're called a fairy wren. They are the tiniest little wrens, and the females are brown, and these ones are blue, and they spend forever tap, 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 tapping at the window. And I always worry they're going to hurt their beak, but they spend days coming and having a tap, and then they have a beautiful call, and they sit on the chair and they call away, and it is just so lovely to hear. You can hear it right through our house, so it really is gorgeous. So who has some small birds in their gardens? Who's going to tell me about theirs? Peter? What small birds do you have? No? Okay. Anybody else? Mary Ellen or Diane? You've told us about the little baby ones. You've got a hummingbird. Mary Ellen, you're on mute at the moment.
Cherie, I wanted to ask if you had any pied currawongs in your yard. It's like a large blackbird with yellow or white spots on the tail.
No, I haven't seen any of those. No, not that hasn't. The closest we've got to that is our magpies.
And did you take the pictures of the birds on your slideshow?
Most of them, yes. Most of them, you know, are from my own garden.
Very nice. That picture on my background is one that I took for the photo contest that they started. That was last week. This week it's dogs. But I had so much fun going out and trying to make the birds sit still.
Oh, yes. Last night, I wanted a picture of the little wagtail, because the one I had was, my husband spent forever trying to catch it doing, it was on the water feature. Then as he got near, then it moved further up. And every time he got it into focus, it took off. It was playing games with him last night. It was so funny. I was just laughing because he was snapping away and trying, when I got the pictures, I said, "You missed a few." He said, "It's moved by the time you got there." And this little wagtail was having a lovely time playing around. And he is absolutely gorgeous, and he chirps nonstop when we are outside. He talks away to us whenever he can.
That's great.
Michael sits his desk. I'm at the one end of the house. I'm at the back end of the house with my office. But Michael's put his office into what is basically the dining room. So he looks out at the bird feeders and the arch. And so he's got his camera nearby. And yesterday he was in class and these beautiful lorikeets, the rainbow lorikeets arrived, and he couldn't stop his, and they were sitting looking at him and they were close, and he was in class, he couldn't take up his camera to take a picture.
I was in his class the other day, not probably when the birds were there, but I was in his class.
He was so funny. He said, it was perfect, but I couldn't stop the class to go and focus on a picture.
He should have just taken the picture of the birds and said, hold on, I'll be right back.
I was just taking the picture because your birds are so beautiful. Sometimes you might not even see them a second time.
That's right.
Exactly. Exactly. But he felt he couldn't. He said to me, I was so torn as to whether I should just say, excuse me, and go take, sort of just move across from where he was and take the picture. He thought maybe some of his class would think he was a little loony. But yes, they're beautiful. And so he sits there and he can see them as they arrive and he can take a lot of the pictures. He will then call through to me if I'm not in class and say, he'll just say birds, and then I'll keep the dogs down this end because they go scuttling up and that chases the birds through the window. So then I tiptoe up and I try and see which birds he's talking about at that moment. So yeah, we are so, so fortunate with what we are able to see. We really do see such a variety of the most amazing birds in our gardens.
I got really lucky with all the things I've seen over my lifetime, and I realize more and more sometimes that you're not going to see something more than once. And that's why I take in every scene of the birds that I can, because it's like a pair of beautiful breasts. Sometimes you don't see those again. Maybe sometimes that's the last night that you see them for.
I like the analogy. Oh, yeah. Yes, no, but the birds are.
Here's the swan.
The
swan was chasing the geese out of the water, and I just happened to be resting my knees on the bench, and he chased the geese right up to my feet. And luckily he didn't come any farther because the goose was really screaming, and then he just looked and I had the camera ready and I just took the picture.
That is an amazing picture, Mary.
Sure luck.
Wow. We're very fortunate. We've got black swans here in Perth. We have the most beautiful black swans in Perth. They really are gorgeous. And they go up our river because we've got the sea and the river. Perth is a really beautiful city, I must say. It's a really, really interesting and beautiful city. Right, now let's continue with what we've got. Now, the next one I'm going to go into is some of the birds that we see in the forest, because we've got, it's not big, it's a tiny, what they do is because they are busy building and expanding homes, they keep little they call them something else here, and I'm still trying to work out what they call them. I still call it a forest. Little areas that are natural woodland that is left. And it's really not, and they do this in every suburb. So every suburb has an area that's natural bush, natural habitat, so that the birds and animals can stay in that natural habitat. Yes, Peter.
You could see all those birds in England?
No, Australia.
Okay. Australia.
I live in Perth, Australia.
Is that on the east side?
No, west coast. The only big city in the west coast.
Okay.
It's the only city on the west coast. And so
I've heard it's beautiful down there.
It is. It's amazing. And we realize more and more every day just how fortunately we are and just how great it is that we can hear it. Harry, would you be able to find a YouTube video of the kookaburra, the laughing kookaburra, so that they can hear the sound of the laughing kookaburra? Because it has such a unique sound. Maybe Harry can find it for me. That would be awesome. Great. Thanks, Harry. Now, we've got these so many different colored parrots, as you can see. They are just, we've got rainbow lorikeets, we've got red-capped parrots. The second one in the middle is a red-capped. These ones I've taken, some of the pictures we've taken, you can see in amongst, because they're in amongst the trees, but some of them I've taken because ours weren't clear enough. So I've taken images so you can really see them. There's the red-capped parrot, there's the rainbow lorikeet. There are some of the most beautiful, bright, vivid green parrots that you could ever see. They are the color of the top of the rainbow lorikeet, a combination of those two greens, and that is the entire bird. Ah, they are exquisite. We also have some doves, and they are quite chatty, and they're not scared of the dogs as we're walking. They actually tease the dogs. They walk just far enough ahead, and my little dog, she wants to get to it, and as soon as she gets just a little closer than they would like, then they will flutter off into the bush and sort of watch from the bush, and then as soon as she's gone past, they come back to wherever they were or whatever they were doing. But
I use doves so.
Yes. Yes. Oops, where's he gone? I've lost him. Peter, yes, you were saying you use doves? You're on mute, Peter.
Yeah. Oh, I was muted. Yeah, I use doves sometimes. I used to actually, back when I was younger, I used to train them because they're actually really trainable. They're really smart birds. So I was able to train them to come back to my porch all the time, and they would say hi to us. I mean, not hi, but you know, they would come over to us when we lived in New York.
Wow, that is so awesome. That is really, really special. Right, as Harry has found us our bird, so I'm going to stop sharing and I'm going to see if we can put up the video. I'm not quite sure how to put it up, Harry. Do I just click on it and see if it comes up? Okay, yep. Now let me share. Oh, let's just get rid of the advert. Just wait for an advert that's gone. Skip the advert. All right. Whoa, let's just stop it for a second now. Let's see if I can share. I'll make that small. Let's share my screen. Have I got the right one now? Yeah, there it is. Let's see if you can hear it. I just hope it's going to be loud enough. I'm going to turn the sound right up of it. And let's see if you can hear him, because he is. Can you hear him?
No.
No? Okay, let's see if. Let's see if. Harry, how can I get the sound louder?
You can go to the microphone on the top, on the left bottom side, and choose. Same as system, I think.
Can you do same that as system co-host? Can you do that as co-host for me?
I can do that for myself, but not for you.
Oh, okay. All right. So you say on the left, I go to?
Yeah. You have select a microphone option. You go to same as system.
Same as system. Okay. That's in Zoom, is it?
Oopsie. Yep, in Zoom.
Okay, let me stop sharing for a second and see if I can find it, because I'd really like to do it. Left. Is it under more?
Yeah, it's under mute option. You have mute, like.
Yes.
You
okay.
Have an up arrow. Yeah.
Yes. Arrow. Yep. Which one do I choose?
I think you have to choose same as system and then try playing it.
AMS, I haven't got AMS.
Yeah, AOL, because it makes it easier if you can play off of AOL.
AOL, I don't think I've got it. what a pity. Well, what I do suggest is if you can, I'll put the URL link, into the news, into the email. so that you can listen to them, because it is the most amazing sound. Harry, could you play it from you? As co-host?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, sure. Super. All right, Harry's going to play it for us. So let's see if we can get it up. Harry's going to see if he can get it up for us.
Just give me a second.
Okay, because this is a sound that you don't hear anywhere else in the world. Okay. Okay, we're not not hearing anything, Harry.
Please wait.
Okay, no, we'll wait. But while we're talking, here we go. Let's see if it comes through this time. Not yet. Okay, let's see. No, it's not coming through, Harry. No, not coming through. Okay.
Give me some time. You can continue the class.
Okay, perfect. Thank you so much. That's awesome. Can you, let's go back. Can you go back to me? All right, excellent. Now, let's continue with, I've lost what I'm doing here. Yeah, there we go, screen sharing. The most interesting things that I have had, my thing is really playing around now because I've left where I was. Sorry about that. One of the other beautiful birds, or some of the other beautiful birds that we see, are in the park in front of us. Our house has a little forest 50 meters from the back. And when you open our front gate, it's not onto the street, it's onto a park. So in front of us is this beautiful park where children play and everybody has fun. Now, in the park, we have the gwala. He is a pink parrot, a gray and pink, very, very fluffy front, pink front and gray back. And they are in flocks. You get 30 or 40 of them at a time. And they find a particular tree they like. And at night, the tree, literally the branches sag from the number of parrots sitting on it. And they set themselves up there, and they have a lovely call. And so they're called a gwala. And then you also get a series of the most beautiful parrots that are the sulfur-crested cockatoo. And they put up their crests, and there are times that they come in and feed on the grass. And the grass becomes white. It's just covered in these parrots. And they feed for 20 minutes or so, and then they fly away and off they're gone. And there might be another week before they'll come back again and feed there, because they've got their places that they go to and at different places around the area where they go and feed. But they are beautiful, and they're white. Cockatoos. So they are really beautiful. And then, of course, there's our green one that I was talking about. He's such a vivid green. He's really, really beautiful with his coloring. And he really settles, and we find them, there's normally five or six together, and they fly across the path in front of us, and they are really gorgeous. And then, of course, we get the magpie. Now, the magpie is a very interesting bird. He collects all kinds of everything that's shiny, including eyes. So the biggest problem is when they are breeding and they've got their nests nearby, they will attack anything that comes too close to the nest. But they go for the shiniest part of the body, which of course is your eyes. So if you see a magpie coming towards you, you always make sure your eyes are covered, because they see this thing that sparkles and they think that that is danger. They come towards it. So
one time they came out. I have a story of them coming after my daughter.
Oh, wow. Tell us, Peter.
Well, basically, we were out one day, and she was wearing a shirt that showed off a little too much cleavage. And then they saw that. I guess it was sparkly or something, and it was reverberating the sun. And then they came after her, and they were trying to peck at that area on the cleavage. I said, this is exactly why you need to not be wearing that. She does recommend, though, that you get custom bra fittings, because a lot of people don't have the right bra size in here, I noticed.
Oh, Peter! You are naughty. All right. Now, yes, look, the magpie also remembers. If you have hurt it or done something to it, it remembers that person, and it'll go for that person every time it sees. There'll be other people around, and it'll leave them alone. It'll go for that person because that person has somehow annoyed, irritated, upset them. And so, yeah, magpie is an interesting bird. And the magpies here are called Murray magpies, which is not very good because that's my surname. And so I feel quite bad for them. But the rest of the year, they are very, very docile. But it's just during, I found the way, let me know if you want me to do it for you. Yes. All right. Harry can share the sound for us of the kookaburra. So please go ahead, Harry. That would be awesome. Let's see. Right, there you are. Now you can understand. Now, often there are two of them, and they'll come and they'll be sitting here in the little forest, and it comes in through my window, and I can hear these kookaburra. He's singing still. But so now you understand, it is a unique sound, the kookaburra. It just makes you smile. There's no two ways about it. They really do have the most awesome sound. Thank you so much, Harry, for doing that for me, because it really made it worthwhile. Right. Is there any other bird song that you love? What bird that sings that you really love their song? Anybody? Sherry, Diane, Debbie? Marianne, Peter, yes.
Yeah, I have there's some really good bird songs. Some of my favorite ones is this one.
Not quite a bird song.
That's the turn.
Yes. Oh, by the birds. Now that is a unique turn on the birds. I love it. Thank you, Peter. That was awesome. All right. I don't think any of us could top that. That was great. Wow. Thank you, everybody. I hope you've enjoyed today. We're chatting about the different birds. I hope you've enjoyed the ones that I've been able to share. There is just one other that's not here because it's not from Australia. These birds were in my garden in South Africa. There was a family of owls. And the crows used to come and disturb them. And I would chase the crows away. And I would talk to the owls and apologize for the crows being so rude. And the owls actually started to hoot back. And in the morning when I went out, the male owl would always hoot at me. And he would hoot. And if I didn't answer, he would fly and fly quite low over my head just to say, I'm here. And then they put up an owl box in the tree. And they had two little baby owls. And one fell out of the nest. And I climbed up a ladder and I put it back. And I wasn't sure if it would be accepted, because usually if you've touched a bird, the mother's doesn't accept it. But both mom and dad were watching me. And they both flew there and they looked after the little one. And they were quite happy that I had put it back in the nest. I spoke to them all the time that I was doing it. And then about 2 weeks later, this little thing got turfed out by its brother again. And it decided it didn't want to go back up there because it was tired of being kicked, and it was determined to stay on the ground. So we made an area where the dogs and cats couldn't get to it. It was, we sort of fenced it off so that we could make it a safe area for this little thing, lots of bush for it to climb in and so on. And it was reared from there by its family. And it was such a beautiful little owl. It really was. It was had the most amazing features and face. And when it was sitting on the ground, it always looked so busy and so full of life. It was really the most amazing little owl. And it made me understand, that was the one thing I really was sorry to leave South Africa. When I left South Africa, I really was quite sorry to leave this beautiful little bird behind. I'm just hoping that I've been able to find. There it is.
I'm as free as
it's a poor bird. Right. Here are just some of the pictures of the, I'm going to share them with you, of these owls that I took, taking a few seconds to come up. I hadn't thought of putting the owls up. This is Mother Owl. She's very tall and elegant. This is their eagle owls. And Dad is fatter and rounder, and he would sit and talk to me for a long time every day. And then he had these most beautiful these beautiful eyes and he always looked sort of elegant as he stood. This is the baby down on the ground, and always looked so cross with these big yellow eyes, as much as to say, "Look at me, I'm strong." And all he had was these downy little feathers that wouldn't go anywhere. They were as soft as could be. But he was beautiful. He was really the most gorgeous little baby owl that we had. So that was a very special experience that I had. And then the four of them stayed around the home once. And then, unfortunately, I moved to Australia as far as the owls go, because I really do miss my owls. Right. Thank you. Oh, wow. I hope everybody's had some fun today and been able to hear about the different ones. If you are interested in sending pictures of your birds, please send them to Liz at Get Set Up. She will send them to me, and I will be able to put them into some of my presentations if you would like, when we talk about birds again, and we can actually talk about the ones that you've got in your gardens as well. If you want a recording of the session, please get some help. Get help at Get Set Up, and I will send you an email, and you can give us some feedback as to whether this is the sort of a social hour you would like. I'm hoping to do a social hour on what's on my bucket list. What do you want to still do? Lots of things that are on your bucket list. I'm hoping that might come up even next week. What's on your bucket list? And so if you can give us more ideas of things that you would like to see, please feel free to add it to the feedback, because we're changing our format and we're getting more interactive as we go along. When you book, you can now click on it and click it to add a friend, send an email to a friend, and then they can also join the class and you can discuss things with them afterwards, which I think is an awesome idea. And if there's anybody you know or think would like to join us with Get Set Up, please spread the word, and so we have more and more people available.
Thank you, right. Sue. It was wonderful.
I hope you enjoyed. Thank you very much, Mary Ellen. I hope
I think it would be good if the people who
very took- enjoyable.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. It was a great time.
Great. Yes, Mary Ellen, what did you think we might do?
I think if the people who took pictures of the birds in the other class brought their pictures to your class to share, it would be a great idea.
Oh, that would be awesome. Can you try and suggest that? That would be really
I will
awesome.
Suggest that because some of the fantastic. People all over the country took such beautiful pictures of birds.
Oh, wow. That would make it really special. Yes, please. That would be such a good idea. Thank you for doing that. That really sounds great. Well, everybody, I hope you have a great evening. I'm going to go and have some morning tea. And I will be seeing all of you again, hopefully in the not too distant future. Thank you, Harry, for all your help today. It was great. And thank you, everyone, for joining us.
Thank have you. A great day. This is a great time.
Excellent. Bye-bye. I'm glad you enjoyed thank it. You. Bye.